Now, there have been more big shifts in the media industry today as mining executives move in on Channel 7 and 10. The former head of Woodside Petroleum, Don Volta, has replaced David Leckie as chief executive of Seven West Media. Meanwhile, Gina Rinehart has bought another 39 million shares in Network 10. It comes as she threatens to sell her stake in Fairfax if she doesn't get three seats on the board. Well, tonight, Fairfax journalists have released a video calling for support for the company's Charter of Independence. It's in response to Ms. Rinehart's reported refusal to sign that charter, which prevents board members from interfering in newspaper content and hiring or firing editorial staff. Now, in a moment, I'll be speaking to Andrew Jaspan, a former editor-in-chief of The Age newspaper and also currently in charge of The Conversation website, and also media analyst Peter Cox, about the impact of this first. Though, let's take a look at that video.
I'm a journalist.
I'm a journalist.
I'm a journalist.
I'm a journalist. And we support the Fairfax Charter of Editorial Independence. And this is what it means.
It means we report the affairs of our nation and the world fairly and fully.
We have respect for the truth and the public's right to know.
We present all sides of the story.
We are committed to the public interest.
We don't allow personal interests to undermine our reporting.
We expose the truth despite the risks to ourselves.
We tell the whole story, regardless of any commercial, political or personal interests.
It's vital that we keep independent journalism alive.
Well, there's the video. With me here in the studio is Peter Cox. Andrew Jaspan is in Melbourne. Thanks both of you for coming in tonight. Andrew Jaspan, is this in a sense a declaration of war, given that we've got Gina Rinehart saying, if you don't let me onto the board under my own terms, I'm out? And the journalist saying, you've got to sign.
Well, look, I salute all those journalists for doing that. But frankly, that just doesn't wash with potentially new owners in Gina Rinehart and others. And that's really what that advertisement is focused on. I think she feels that the Fairfax papers are way out on the left and she's way out on the right. And she's not really wanting to make this play on Fairfax for financial or money reasons. It's pure politics play to change the debate in Australia around issues that really concern her, like the carbon tax and of course, climate change issues in general and mining tax issues.
Peter Cox, is there any question about who will win this?
Well, there is, I think, as to whether Gina has the legs to stay in there for the long period. I mean, she has nearly 20% of the shares now. That would give her, let's say, two positions on the board she'll get. There's eight members on the board, so that will not give her control over the board. If she really wants to be able to drive this, she really has to make a takeover offer for the company and get control, and then she will have a majority say.
There seems to be this perception that mining bosses are taking over the media industry. There were changes at Seven today. Is that a fair perception, do you think?
Well, remember, Kerry Stokes comes from a mining background as well, that the mining interests have been very successful for him as well as his media interests. And, you know, that's where his relationships are like, if you like, and he's taken this chief executive in. Perhaps not many of us in the industry would have expected that. I mean, David Leckie has been an institution in the industry. He's been highly successful at Nine, highly successful at Seven. But Seven now is just a little bit on the edge. Nine's done pretty well over the last month.
Andrew Jaspan, is this something that only journalists, members of the media really care about, or does this, you know, really kind of have carriage in the public mind?
Look, I really care about it. I'm sure you
do as
well.
But you're a journalist.
that's what I'm saying. I really care about it, and I think a large number of people out there probably do, but I think most people probably, sadly to say, don't. And I think that's why this is worth raising as an issue, and it's why I think it's good that the Fairfax journalists are saying something. But frankly, I think all of this will just fall on deaf ears when it comes to Gina Rinehart. And my own view is that if she doesn't get her way, she's already shown that she will play games with the Fairfax board. The shares at an all-time low. If she dumps her 20% shareholding that she now has, the shares will fall, and she said she might rebuy them back at, you know, I don't know if they'll fall to 45 cents or 40 cents, but she's just playing games with the board, and she has one object here, which is to gain control.
Do you accept in any way that she could be a white knight investor, as has been described?
Look, she'll put money in on the same in the same way that, for example, the Wall Street Journal in the US was struggling, and Rupert Murdoch has put a lot of money into the Wall Street Journal, but he's repositioned the paper in a different direction. And I think she will, if she gets control, put money in. I mean, let's not forget that Fairfax is worth probably just over $1 billion now, and she has $27 billion in her war chest. So this is a small play to achieve something much bigger. And my own view is she will attain control, but let's have the debate. And I'm really pleased that you and others are interested in having that debate, because that's what we've tried to do through our website, The Conversation, and I'm delighted to see other media plays as well. Let's have that debate.
You got your plug in. Andrew Jaspan, thanks very much for joining us tonight. Peter Cox as well. Appreciate your time.
Thanks, Hamish.